Hey folks, have you ever placed a pot on your fire and seen this list and wondered, what does all this actually mean? Have you ever tried a recipe and wondered, what the heck is this cooking buff all about anyway? Well, in this video, we are going to explore these cooking buffs, what they are, how to use them, and is there a way to optimize them to your advantage? So let's get into it. Before we get on the topic of buffs, I want to address a food-related update. Recently, N-Night rebalanced hydration, fullness, and health values for consumables in regular and hard survival. I have personally noticed a huge difference in this update because prior to this, hydration and hunger were never ever really filled while playing in hard survival. It usually required 4 pieces of grilled meat, 2 pots of water to fill my hydration, or like 4 stews to fill my character up on both. Now the quantities have essentially been cut in half. I feel like this update is nicely balanced now, as maintaining the food and hydration of your character is no longer a tedious task. And the thing I hated the most about the old setup was how your stamina was always zapped. It literally was never full, and now that has all been corrected. So I'm happy with this update. One related thing to mention is you used to be able to eat raw fish and it would fill you up pretty decently. Now that has been lowered, but it does not appear that it has been lowered as much as just raw meat. And we all know, like, if you eat raw meat, you hardly get filled up at all. Again, you should see this change for normal and hard survival. I'm assuming peaceful and hard mode are already balanced. Now, in case you're wondering, where the heck am I finding all of these small updates? If you go onto Steam, view the main page for Sons of the Forest, it looks like the only update that has been made recently was update 15. However, if you go to the discussions tab and then news, you can find all the hotfixes that have occurred since update 15. And this is where I found the rebalance update for food, hydration, and health. And you can see that there are some other food related updates, so I think N-Night has dialed in the cooking buffs. I point that out because I kind of hate it when my videos land up being outdated because something changed with the update. So okay, what are cooking buffs? When you place a pot on the fire and hover over the gear button, you'll see these yellow symbols. The symbols tell you what you can boost with your buff. Now think about it. Where have you seen these symbols before? If I were to summarize the buffs, I'd say the axe will boost your chopping ability so you can chop trees down faster. The bicep curl will boost your strength so you can level up faster. The eye, this will increase your stealth. The 3 squiggly lines, this will boost your warmth. The dude chilling, this will boost your resting capabilities. Then you see those arrows. I believe those represent the strength of the buff, and I have experimented with this as part of this video, and I'll be discussing my interpretation of those results later on. So, I'm at a base of mine that it's really lacking a defensive perimeter. So why not fix it up with a stew that'll boost my chopping abilities and increase my strengths faster, right? Let's start out with the boiled meat first. Boiled meat has a strength buff and has 2 arrows. While that is cooking, let's get some baseline data, shall we? While I'm grabbing the baseline data, let's just take a moment and talk about strength. So the actions that help you level up your strength are swinging any kind of weapon or picking up logs. And from what I understand, there isn't an observable difference if you swing a stick versus swinging the katana. That means you gain the same level of strength whether you're swinging that same stick or swinging your axe during combat. Picking up logs is the other action that will increase your strength, and picking up logs increases your strength a little better than swinging. Further, it is exponentially harder to level up your strength the higher your strength level goes, meaning it'll take about 100 swings to level up from 1 to 2, and about 275 swings to level up from 2 to 3. And your strength maxes out at 50. When you level up in strength, what does it actually do? It actually has nothing to do with how much damage you could deal to the enemies, or it doesn't make you chop trees any faster. Instead, it increases your health by giving you extra bars on your meter, which increases your ability to take enemy damage. I don't know the exact numbers, but basically, if you're on day 1 and your strength is on the lower end of the spectrum, I bet you all it'll take is 1 hit to send you here. Or here, as opposed to day 100 and you have a strength level of, let's say, 40, you may be able to take a few more hits before I'm sure you get it. This is really the only buff that requires that much of a background, and I do want to say the information about strength dates back to March 2023. I looked through the updates, so I do not think anything has changed about strength since people were writing and doing videos about it, and I didn't see anything while creating this video that contradicted the nearly year-old information I got from the internet. Whew, okay. That was more talking about strength than I was expecting, and my boiled meat has been done for a while, so let's check that out. While I was giving that explanation, I had the strength meter blown up so you could gauge how much of the strength bar increased while I chopped trees or lifted logs, and it wasn't much. Last time I actually saw my level up, it was at 34, so if anything, this shows how hard it is to level up once you get to the upper echelon of the strength levels. With that being the case, let's see if we can see a noticeable difference in the movement of the meter upon taking a sip of the boiled meat. After doing quite a bit of chopping, there was a noticeable difference in movement in the strength meter, so it does appear the boiled meat buff does help you level up your strength faster, even for someone like me who has a higher strength level. Given my hypothesis is that the arrows above the buff symbol represent the strength of the buff, the boiled meat with two arrows probably will do better than the lumberjack juice, which has one arrow, and the protein shake will blow all of those out of the water because it has three arrows. For dramatic effect, let's do a side-by-side comparison of the protein shake and lumberjack juice. The difference between those two recipes and the boiled meat is that these two recipes also have the axe buff. However, I do not think the axe buff makes you swing faster, which would help you level up faster. Rather, I think the axe buff seems to put more power in your swing so that the tree goes down faster. So with my tests, I started at different places on the meters for each recipe. If I wanted to make things really controlled, I could have had the same starting point for each recipe and say chopped three trees, picked up five logs to see how much actually changed following that exact process, but this is really more of an observational study and not an in vitro study. I plotted out the strength meters before and after doing activities that increase your strength, and the results demonstrate my hypothesis was right. The lumberjack juice only has one arrow on its buff and didn't yield amazing results. If you compare boiled meat to the protein shake, you can see a difference in the start and end result, but the protein shake arguably has more of an increase than the boiled meat. So the arrows do represent the strength of the buff, and I'd say if you wanted to level up your strength quicker, consuming the protein shake will get you there faster, and it will get you there faster particularly if you are at a strength level in your mid-30s, since it gets harder to level up exponentially as you continue on with the levels. However, this game incorporates a fair amount of resource management. If you compare the recipe for boiled meat versus the protein shake, more than likely you will choose to make the boiled meat because the ingredients are easier to come by. So there you have it. The strength buff gets you to the next strength level faster, and the arrows above the buff tell you how fast you can get there. I do want to say we actually didn't cover all of the recipes that contain the strength buff. The one that was left out was Greg. But with what we know, we could assume that the order of the buff strengths would be as shown. The next buff is one that I kind of covered already because we have seen it and I did talk about it as part of the strength buff. It's the axe buff, and it allows you to chop faster. I mentioned before that the buff is not done with more swings. Rather, each swing packs more of a punch so you're able to chop down the tree faster. So the buff allows you to chop down trees with fewer swings. The recipes with the axe buff include Kelvin Special, Protein Shake, Greg, and then Lumberjack Juice. You can gauge this buff by the number of chops, but what I am going to say is the lumberjack juice really does have a noticeable difference in how quickly the trees go down. Provided I demonstrated that the arrows represent the strength of the buff, it's no wonder the lumberjack juice is the buff where I notice the chopping capabilities the most. However, look at all the resources you need for the lumberjack juice. It doesn't seem like a whole lot, but if you're in your first few days and just started to build a base, the lumberjack juice may be asking a lot in terms of resources. So you know what? If you're starting to build a base and the cannibals are getting all mad and attacking you, just cook up some Greg. Let's talk about stealth next. I'm going to be upfront. Stealth is kind of tricky. I don't think this game is about stealth, at least not in how we are used to seeing it in video games. I think this game is more about evading the enemies when you are ill-equipped or outnumbered. But I tested out the buffs on stealth kills anyway to see if I was wrong with this assumption. Needless to say, I had a lot of what I would call stealth fails. But anyway, there are two recipes that include a stealth buff, and that includes the cream of mushroom soup and Greg. So let's see how successful I am with stealth without the buff. So I'm crouching down, and you can't hear me walking nearly as much. But like I'm gonna stand up here and you could hear me. Oh, see, yeah, he heard me. Now let's see how good I am at stealthing with the cream of mushroom soup. And there's a lady. Oh, there's two other people, but let's just see if she will actually be able to see me. Oh no, she sees me, and I'm gonna have to blur out her boobies. Okay, so I found one of the bigger dudes. He's just kind of behind those bushes. Right there. So far, so good. I am kind of starting to hear like somebody's following me. Oh, yep. Oh, they both got me. Okay, I guess my cover is blown. I'm in trouble. So yeah, those were my stealth fails. Before I get into things further, I want to point out that the two recipes with stealth buffs have one arrow above the symbol. So it doesn't matter which recipe you consume, you'll have the same level of stealth for either one. When you are crouching, you've probably noticed this thing. This is the gauge that tells you how visible you are to the enemies, and you'll notice when I stand, it goes full circle before it disappears. That tells me that when the circle is complete, it means you're more visible, and when the circle and I are ghosted out, it means you are less visible. In this footage here, it is never completely full, and that is basically simulating the peripheral vision of the enemies, which, hey, there's some realism in there. That's great. However, if you throw in some vegetation, I noticed the stealth performs really well as the game takes it into account and further reduces your visibility to the enemy. In this footage, I'm hiding from a red dude that's pretty darn close. And had the bush not been there, I probably would have been noticed much earlier. I got found eventually, but I was seeing how far I could push it. Now that we have kind of cracked the code on stealth, can you guess where this might really matter? Here I am in the rebreather cave, and I'm coming up to the point where you encounter the creepies for the first time. I think stealth may not work very well in caves due to the narrow chambers and lack of vegetation. I probably will be detected because the layout of the chambers forced you to get so close to the creepies that you'll just inevitably be detected. But I'm gonna try anyways and be as stealthy as possible and see if I actually get detected. So let's see what happens. Okay, so that didn't play out very well, but I didn't want to give up right away. Just outside of the cave, creepies were spawning, and I tried sneaking up on them just to see at what point do they sense my presence. Surprisingly, you can get pretty darn close to them before the creepies notice you. It felt like you could get closer to the creepies than the cannibals before being detected. So it's like the cannibals seem to sense you at a greater distance while the creepies have a detection radius that is slightly smaller. In my opinion, totally based on my observations. So maybe the narrow chambers in the caves won't be so problematic after all. I also tried to optimize the stealth buff by applying leaf armor on to see how that turned out, and I didn't notice much of a difference when I was sneaking up on the creepies. But I wanted to see how the leaf armor and a stealth buff played out in the caves together. So I entered the rebreather cave again. And just because I don't know where else to fit this in, the leaf armor is a stealth armor, and if you put it on, you will notice you cannot hear your character as much. The other stealth armor is the hide armor, which can be crafted using deer or moose skin and cloth. Okay, so far so good. And I think I'm keeping enough of a distance away from the creepies so they don't seem to detect my presence. But you can't see them on the side. So I'm somewhat close, but not close enough. But I am kind of hearing some following me right now, so let me see. I'll just turn around in a second. Okay, so I got caught there.
Now, I didn't want to give up right there. Like, maybe this takes some practice, so I went up further into the chamber to do a little bit more research.
Okay, a puffy is coming in hot, but I'm not hearing them following me. Okay, I think I'm pretty much in the clear there.
The chamber I went up was where the stun gun is located, so I had to turn around and go back the way I came, testing out the stealth buff and leaf armor combination for its effectiveness. Despite a puffy here or there, overall, I think this was a successful run. And I do think if you consume a stealth buff and put on stealth armor, then you can sneak past a lot of the creepies and get through some of the harder parts in the caves. Now, you'd think this would be it for the stealth portion of the video, but I also want to say that the buff plus stealth armor are also a godsend for hunting. I don't use my gun unless I really have to, and I haven't used my gun for hunting at all. My go-to is usually the spear or the bow and arrow. One of the hardest animals to catch, in my opinion, is the rabbit. So check out how close you can get to these guys to go in for your kill. So yeah, if you haven't tried the stealth cooking buff and the leaf armor combination to go hunting, I really suggest that you do. You can definitely stock up on a lot of meat with this combination. All right, I think I gathered enough data to draw some conclusions on the stealth cooking buff. You can try to do stealth kills all you want, but the buff probably doesn't make you any better at stealth kills. The purpose of the stealth buff is not to enhance your ability to carry out stealth kills, but rather you become more effective at evading the enemies. It isn't perfect for use in the caves, but you can evade quite a few enemies. The stealth buff makes you rather proficient at hunting, being able to sneak up on animals that are usually very skittish and can detect you from far distances. And lastly, using stealth armor will optimize your stealth buff, so you would be able to hunt and evade the enemies even more effectively if you apply stealth armor while you're consuming a stealth buff. Now, before I get into the next cooking buff, if you are finding this video helpful or entertaining, please give it a like as it helps people find me. Feel free to subscribe if you want to hear more from me, and you may also join my Discord if you want to hang out. The link to the Discord is in the description box. Oh, the winter has graced itself upon us on the island, and I'm cold and wet all the time. At this time, I suffer absolutely no consequences from these conditions, but the key point is at this time. You see, in the forest, you did get health hits from being too cold. Like, you could die from being too cold for too long and not doing anything about it. So you might as well watch this segment to prepare yourself, because I can guarantee you that Endnight will update the game and we will face consequences for not staying warm. So I want to talk about the warmth buff, but I also want to say that this is probably the buff that needs the most improvement, and I'm hoping Endnight will polish off this buff when we also start to see consequences from being in the cold in the future. And I say this because when I was getting footage for this video, I felt like I didn't see the buff working at all. And I started to think that I was going crazy, because I thought I remember being able to drink something with the warmth buff when I was cold and wet, and that annoying sign would go away because the buff was activated. So please tell me this was a thing and that I'm not going crazy. So because this buff was a little funky, I'll discuss what I found and why there needs to be improvements, because as it stands, it seems like the buff just isn't working. Now, some ways you could stay warm without the buff include building a base, getting the winter jacket, and then building a fire or lighting a torch. But let's say you can't be bothered to do any of those things, but you are willing to whip up a recipe with the food buff. To get the warmth food buff, you could cook cooked ramen noodles, chicken noodle soup, or eggnog. Now, as I said, this buff was acting really wonky for me, but basically, given what we know about buffs, the chicken noodle soup and cooked ramen wouldn't warm you up like the eggnog due to the strength of the buffs. So I tried putting on clothes that didn't have a high warmth rating to see if this notification would go away, but it wouldn't. Then I tried putting on the winter jacket, which has the highest warmth rating. Like, certainly the combination of a warmth buff and the winter jacket would warm my bones, but no,
That didn't happen. So the only time I saw the warmth buff work was when I consumed some cooked ramen noodles and the notification still didn't go away. However, after I sat in front of a fire for a little bit and then started walking around after being in front of the fire, the notification didn't come up again. But I don't know if the warming effect from the buff was delayed or if it was the fire itself that removed the notification. So I'm kind of at a loss for this buff. The reason I'm moving on to the conclusions is because I think something got messed up specifically with the warmth buff in one of the hotfixes, and it's an issue I have since reported in the community hub. I believe the warmth buff will eventually warm you when you are cold, and how long you stay warm will be dependent on your clothing and the strength of the buff. For example, if you're in your pajamas in the middle of winter and you consume the chicken noodle soup or the cooked ramen, those are two recipes that only have one arrow for its strength, you will stay warm for, I don't know, let's say 10 minutes as opposed to 30 minutes if you consume the eggnog, because the eggnog has three arrows. I haven't mentioned this yet, but the yellow symbol is essentially your timer for the buff once it is activated. So the other buffs had essentially the same amount of activation time associated with them. If what I'm guessing about the warmth buff is true, you'd see the activation period for the cooked ramen and chicken noodle soup deactivate faster than the eggnog. The other way the warmth buff may work would be that the activation time is the same across all of the warmth buffs, but would only work for certain clothing items. For example, you can wear clothing items with really low warmth rankings only while the eggnog buff is activated because it has the three arrows. Basically, you'd have to try on different clothes to see which ones work to get rid of the cold and wet notification for the buff you consumed. So I'm going to leave this segment at that, and that means when they fix this buff, I'll have to do some sort of an update, which really annoys me, but that's what you get when you cover a game in early access, so whatever. Let's move on to the next buff, which is the rest buff. The rest buff can be achieved by cooking and consuming either eggnog or chicken noodle soup, and its effectiveness can be realized by looking at the moon meter. The moon meter can be replenished by sitting on a bench or chair or by sleeping. When Sons of the Forest first came out, there was a debate on whether building a base was actually needed, and the basis against building a base was that there really wasn't any negative consequences for not building a base. However, there was an update that happened when I first started this channel, so like we're talking June, July, where the rest is replenished better when you sleep indoors. That means you could sleep in bunkers or build a base, or you could skip that and just know that you'll be spending several minutes a day sitting in furniture. When your rest is depleted, you will find that your stamina or vitality is depleted. Rest, as well as making sure your character is fed and hydrated, all contribute to replenishing your vitality. If we look at sleeping without the buffs, you'll find that clothing affects your quality of sleep, and if you hover over the clothing items in your inventory, you'll find that each clothing item has a ranking for rest, the PJs being ranked the highest. First, let's look at the baseline, which is seeing how sleep without a buff impacts your rest, both by sleeping under a tarp versus sleeping in a base. And I'm going to wear pajamas to get the best case scenario for the baseline. Okay, so this is your rest without a buff in a cozy base. Like, there doesn't really seem to be a reason to combine a resting buff with sleep in a base. This suggests that the resting buff is meant to be used if you are out and about, and let's say you can't make it back to your base, so you need to sleep under a tarp. That is a completely plausible scenario, because have you seen the Sons of the Forest world? And I found that what you wear to bed, especially if you have to sleep under a tarp, really does matter. Like, it really does. So keeping in mind, the buffs can be life-changing for your quality of sleep if you are sleeping under a tarp, I looked at the sleep quality while in PJs with each buff. Again, the chicken noodle soup has one arrow and the eggnog has two, so theoretically, and we're probably going to prove this, the eggnog should give you better sleep than the chicken noodle soup. Oh,
Okay, so I think the chicken noodle soup looks like it gave me a better quality sleep because when I slept, my moon meter wasn't completely depleted like it was when I slept after consuming the eggnog. So I'm guessing the quality of sleep between the chicken noodle and the eggnog is probably comparable. And it doesn't make a huge difference which one you consume, but the eggnog probably gives you just a teensy bit more rest. So as I said, the clothing matters when you're not consuming a buff, but if you consume a buff, they do not seem to matter at all. What I mean by that is, well, I'll just show you an example. This footage here is a side-by-side comparison of sleep quality with the eggnog buff applied while wearing pajamas and the spacesuit. Here, it seems like it does not seem to make any difference as far as I can tell. So the clothes really only matter if you have not consumed a buff just before hitting that Z to go to bed. That was unexpected to me because I really thought I was going to go on some kind of tangent talking about how the clothing will optimize the buff, kind of like how the leaf armor optimizes the stealth buff. But I was finding that that was not the case. You could pretty much wear the most uncomfortable thing before going to bed as long as you have a buff and your sleep won't get impacted at all. The very last thing I want to say about sleep is that I've seen people question whether energy drinks or energy mixes impact your sleep quality at all. Now here, the moon meters are a result of sleeping in a tarp in the pajamas, one with no energy drinks and the other with. And when I look at these results, I'm thinking no at face value, but yes when I think about how the energy mix consumption might impact your day, because you will have to consume more energy concoctions or sit for a bit to replenish your rest later on, whereas if you slept without the energy drink, you wouldn't have to do those things until maybe later in the day. So I think overall, it doesn't really matter that much. Now, let's talk about how rest can be replenished by just sitting in furniture. This part is pretty simple. If your moon meter is depleted, you can sit in furniture and it may take about 28 seconds to get out of the red with no buff at all. When you compare that to sitting with the chicken noodle soup or the eggnog, it takes you 28 seconds also to get out of the red. Okay. So after observing these results, I thought that maybe the buff accelerates over time to get your moon meter full. Like maybe there's some sort of exponential function where overall you can replenish your rest faster with the eggnog buff than the chicken noodle buff or nothing at all. But I was finding that was not the case. Whether you consume a buff or nothing at all, it takes you over a minute to replenish your moon meter. So this is either something that Ennite has overlooked or this is by design. I say that because the incentive to build a base is really dependent on the player for the most part. Like, I did not care to learn the building system when I first played this game all the way through, and this was before I started this channel. After Ennite updated the sleep quality, improving while sleeping indoors, there was a little more of an incentive for me to learn how to build, and then I found I really like stocking up on inventory I run out of the most, like rope for instance. So now I like taking the time to build multiple bases across this giant map, and considering the buffs are not applied to sitting at all, I prefer to sleep at my base. And while I'm fine with replenishing my rest if it's needed by building a chair in the wild, I find that this occurrence happens far too often. Holy! So yeah, there's why I have a small preference to sit and enjoy the view while I'm at my base to replenish my rest. So let's go ahead and summarize this buff now. The rest buff is all about replenishing your moon meter, and you can only do that by sleeping. Consuming a rest buff just before sleeping is more important to use if you are going to sleep under a tarp. However, you can wear whatever clothes you want, so it is not a requirement to get into your PJs if you have a rest buff activated. The eggnog will replenish your rest the most, but there is not a huge difference in what is replenished between the eggnog and chicken noodle soup, in my opinion. And energy drinks impact your rest based on the reduction of the green bar, but it doesn't really matter all that much because you could further replenish your rest in other ways. So let me know if you have anything to add about the buffs. Maybe I missed looking into something, or how do you think the buffs need to be improved? Personally, I like the strength, chopping, and stealth buffs, and I do not have much criticism there, but I really hope they fix the warmth buff by adding consequences and staying out in the cold for too long, and then being able to remedy that by using a buff and clothing combination. And I do think that combination is something that you need to figure out that works. The rest buffs are okay. It does seem to be too easy to sleep under your tarp with a buff activated, so if End Knight really wanted to make base building an absolute necessity, perhaps they shouldn't allow for the buff to replenish so much if you sleep under your tarp. And I'd personally like to see the buffs be applied to sitting and furniture, because it just makes sense as it takes more than a minute to replenish your moon meter completely. But I think that's gonna do it for today. Don't forget to like and subscribe if you want to hear more from me. Join the Discord if you want to hang out. Otherwise, my name is Heather, and thank you for letting me put my game on for you, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye!